again papaya. I'm having this papaya also because of the enzymes. And I like to have something sweet. Because the diet are always craving for sweets. Everyone who's not craving the diet for nothing is a liar. Either he's not on a diet or he's pretending like everything is alright. A lot of my co-competitors say I'm never hungry in a diet. They're never tired in a diet. They have no cravings. They're all liars. And if this would be the case, why do they immediately start eating after the show is over? Why do they start eating french fries, potato chips, chocolates, everything? They have no cravings. I think it's totally normal to suffer in the diet. If I wouldn't be suffering the diet, it wouldn't be a diet at all. And so my replacement for sweets is sometimes, it's almost on a daily basis, my papaya. Deprived of sleep, I wake every night a couple of times up. I go back and forth to the restroom. I'm hungry, I'm craving, and I do twice a day cardio. Train in the afternoons between 60 and 90 minutes, sometimes longer, sometimes less. Only when I'm very, very tired and I'm very exhausted, I take a day break, I take a day off, but mostly I force myself. It's a profession like any other else. For example, if you would be a police officer, you're not in the mood to go to your second shift, you have to go because you know it's your job. In my case, it's the same. But the difference is I like to be world class, and to be world class, you have to give something special. You have to do something extra. If you're not willing doing it, then you should do something else. And I'm willing to sacrifice a lot of things, not my health, but a lot of other things. And I think if you are a competitive bodybuilder and you have a kind of weird lifestyle, you can't make it. You have to pay your dues, you have to go to the gym. If it's rainy, if it's cold, if your girlfriend broke up with you or if your boyfriend broke up with you, you have to go to the gym. It's like, I'm giving all these examples, but that's how it's like, teeth brushing, you have to do it on a daily basis, otherwise there are no results coming. The other hard thing in bodybuilding is you train at least for 10 years, for a decade, before you can make any money. So I'm in this sport not to become a millionaire, to become rich. I'm in this sport because I love the sport, I'm dedicated to the sport, and I knew from begin on I won't make as much income like other people in other sports. Nevertheless, if you're at the top, you like also to have a better lifestyle. And lifestyle is not my only target or goal. The goal is to place high enough and to prove to myself that I'm one of the best. Thank you.
I got you, Hamid.
Come in. I expected you earlier. What about body weight is today? Here's the scale. You've just followed me here. Yeah. 10 days out now, Olympia.
See?
292.6. 292.6. How much this is in kilos? How much? 131.6 kilos. Sounds heavy, but I've still 10 days time, and I think I'll be competing between 280 and 285 probably. This is my trophy from the Arnold Classic. I have still the trophy here because of two reasons. One reason is to motivate me for the upcoming Olympia. The other reason is to remind me how hard it is to achieve a top spot, place number one. So it's a reminder, a good reminder. Mitz, I have here my two chicken breasts. And I have here my sweet potato or yams or whatever. And I have here onions, and I have here tomato in slices. Right. And the diet always high protein, low carbs, low fat, plenty of water. during the daytime, also during the meals, because the more you eat, the more you drink, the more you actually slow down your digestion process. I like to slow down my digestion process to eat less, to have longer a longer period of time my stomach filled up so that I don't eat that much. Normally you shouldn't eat that, you shouldn't drink that much fluids during the meals, but I intentionally do it. And now the weather here is still hot. I'm sweating the whole time. I'm doing lots of cardio. I'm using the tanning bed, so I feel most of the time thirsty. And if I don't drink enough, I feel dehydrated. I become nervous. I become aggravated. So I'm used to drink more and more. And it's also very important to drink lots of water, especially when you are having a high protein intake, because it's a lot of pressure for the kidneys. So to flush all the toxins out, you have to drink also lots of water. And right now, just water, just coffee, tea, no artificial sweetener, actually very plain, no spices here, no pepper, no salt, anyway, no sodium. Take the sodium out by a natural way. This means I avoid egg whites the last 3 weeks because they contain a lot of sodium. So if one word, I cut naturally the sodium out. I don't do any sodium loading. I don't do any potassium loading. The closer I come to the show, the more I watch out what I'm eating, specifically regarding sodium. The less sodium I have in the food, the better it is, and the harder I become. I don't know if you remember 2.5 weeks ago when we had one of our last tapings in the gym, at Powerhouse Gym, I showed you how my, now I don't have any big amounts of fluid, you know, for sure. That's because the sodium goes out slowly and slowly, and I'm getting also harder here. You see this here? Cutting sodium out means also feeling weak, and the closer I come to the show, the more I feel weak. I would say the last 2 weeks are the hardest. But I'll manage this for sure. It's very, very essential and important to train as heavy as possible. A lot of people asking, what does it mean heavy? Heavy means training in the rep range between 6 and I would say 8 reps per set. But in general, if it comes to the upper body, I would say 6-8 reps are pretty heavy. It depends on the recuperation time, depends on your biorhythm, it depends on your food intake, your sleeping habits, so it's always different. But in general, to put size on, you have to train heavy. Even in pre-contest time, you're supposed to train heavy. And if you feel very, very tired, then just skip a training day. Don't go to the gym, stay at home, recuperate. Try to sleep, try to eat more to feel the very next day better. I think you should never train more than 2 or 3 days in a row. Otherwise, you think you are training intense, but you are not. Even after 3 days, you need a break, off-season or pre-contest. Also important to have a good nutrition basis. Should feed your body on a daily basis of protein, with multi-minerals, with vitamins. Otherwise, you get in a kind of stagnation phase. Besides bodybuilding, you shouldn't get obsessed with bodybuilding. You should do something else. You should do something for your brains. You should read newspapers. You should read books. You should watch TV. You should spend time with your kids, with your family. So even if bodybuilding is important to you, nevertheless, you should have a life besides bodybuilding. So for this upcoming Olympia, I'm pretty confident. I'm positive. It's my 7th qualification for the Olympia this year in Rio, and so I have high demands of myself, and I'm looking forward to the show. Thank you. One so-called training log. It started at the 14th of December 98. I'm actually keeping track of my training since I would say 10, 11 years. I write in this book on a daily basis down what I'm training, what kind of supplements I've been taking so far, how I felt during the training, and what kind of poundages I use during the training. I write the exercises down. For example, I'm getting ready now for the Olympia 99. I can compare that what I'm doing right now, the weights which I'm using, whatever, with the time frame during the Arnold's Classic. I'm 10 days out of the Olympia now. I compare this, for example, with that what I have been doing 10 days out of the Arnold's Classic this year. I think it's very, very important and effective as a guy, as a, who is in bodybuilding, as an amateur or as a professional, to keep track what you are doing, because you forget always that what you have been doing so far. Besides that, I have here actually written down, either I do it or my wife does it. She does it actually most of the time. She writes it down, what kind of calories, daily calorie intake I have. For example, we have here the 8th of August 99. It was Sunday. I was eating oats, a banana, strawberries, orange, had a protein shake. In the afternoon, I had rice, I had zucchini, I had a mahi-mahi fish, had a tomato, I had a mango in the afternoon, a half a mango. I had later on a steak, mushroom, potato. I had 5 grams of oil, 50 grams of salad. So she writes down during the diet, but just during the diet, 12 weeks out of the show, on a daily basis, what I'm eating. She writes down the carbs, the protein and the fats. And so at the end of the day or during the day, I know how much I have to eat or how much I've been eating so far. So I can calculate with my calories. If I was today maybe like on this day at 208 grams of carbs, I know if I have to go tomorrow on lower carbs or if I have to increase my carb intake. And I know exactly what I've been eating so far. And I know this also, for example, for the time frame 5, 6, or 7, or 8 years ago. I transfer that, the amount of the calories, in my training log. So one depends of the other. And like I said, I have these two different scripts here, and they go along with each other. It's very, very beneficial. I can advise everyone who is ambitious to have something like that. You shouldn't be lazy. In off-season, I don't write down what I'm eating. But in pre-contest, I always, always write down what I'm eating. And I think this is one of the reasons why I'm a kind of successful in that kind of sport. And that, what I'm eating right now, was written already down before. And so tonight, I will know if I have to eat 10 grams or 15 grams of carbs more or whatever.